Yo, what's up, people? Skate Park Mark back in the kitchen. And it's not that I haven't been cooking. Been making lots of beans and rice, pretty much. And I love my rice with chicken broth, so I make my homemade chicken broth. It's basically, I give a whole chicken a bath for a while, cook them up with some veggies, and it's delightful. Actually, I could probably show you some of this stuff here. Reach in here. Some of my chicken broth. Stuff stank. Oh, here's the end of a salsa. Roasted tomatillo salsa. Also dank. But it's been forever since I've posted anything on this cooking thing. And my YouTube numbers are down, obviously, but who cares? They were never up anyway. But I'm making something real good. I got some sausages here, just kind of sizzling a little bit in the background. This is my breakfast. And what I've found is I just love sausage and bread and ketchup. Just like a snacker. Just like, yeah, so good. All right, what am I making right now? I'm making Quincy Jones Thriller Ribs. These came recommended from my mom. She is also sponsoring this project here. Thank you, mother. Also, Oprah really likes them. And so anyway, I'm just kind of freestyling here. I don't have the kitchen ready or anything like that, but I just thought, hey, this is such a good thing to cook that I'm just gonna just kind of keep everybody in the loop. So what I'm missing, and I went to the grocery store quick, they didn't have a spike seasoning. And that's a bummer, because I'm thinking that this is just going to be a lot better with spike seasoning. So I'm going to have to kind of come up with some special replacement for spike seasoning. And I can't just use Accent, because that's also in the recipe. So I got to come up with something else. I'm thinking spike's probably like a barbecue rub. Because these are baby back ribs, so. Reading through the instructions, also just learned that these ribs marinate for 2 days. I'm glad I wasn't planning on cooking these today. So, good news, these vegetables, and I mean, it sounds absolutely delicious. So what I'm gonna do is do pieces here. First of all, you gotta get the spices mixed up, and then you make another garlic spice rub, and then we create a whole bed of vegetables that they're gonna these ribs are gonna marinate in. So I'm gonna go about mixing up some veggies, and mixing up some spices, chopping up some veggies, and then we're gonna put this together. And then in the tinfoil thing, and we'll let it marinate for a couple days. Then we'll cook it. Quincy Jones Thriller Ribs coming at you. You know, I'm pumping music in the background, but I've learned you can't just have that background music going in your vids. Those get shut down, copyright infringement. Tried to turn the music off. Just wanted to touch base here though, let everybody know. Come up with some seasonings. This is simply some pepper, Accent, and then I found a substitute for the spike, and it's gonna not be good, but as good. But anyway, it's some Morton's seasonal. Morton. Didn't smell as bad as some of my other spices that have been sitting up there for ages. Okay, so we got this, and we're gonna cover this with our rib. We're gonna cover our ribs with this, and I'll show you that. All right, next move, vegetables. We're mincing them, doing a lot of chopping. I just wanted to give you a quick look though and show you the veggies. Aww. There we go. Beautiful. We got green peppers, red peppers, yellow peppers. Underneath that, you can't really see it.
jalapenos. Well, these guys are quick rants.
It's the thuggish, ruggish bone. That's what I was just listening to. I'd turn it off. I'd rap to it, but you know, I can't rap like Bone, so. Bone with the bone with the thug won't follow. Okay, so I've been preparing stuff. Prep cook Mark here, and what we have, I'll show you. Okay, it turns out we weren't mincing, but we were just simply slicing thinly our peppers and our onions. Let's see here, we got this little mixture here that I showed you. It's our seasoning. We also have this, which is garlic and jalapeno. That one's minced. So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna take, let me see here, I gotta mix up this. Let me mix up the spice a little bit more. We're just gonna take a quarter of this spice here, apparently, and just rub it on there. So, kind of sprinkling it on right now. Okay, so I'll show you as we work it, as we work the mixture. I don't have very much on there, I'm seeing. I don't know what I'm filming, of course. Roll with the bone, with the bone, follow. Let me hear you holler. All right, so that's a base layer rub, basically, base layer rub. I'm gonna take the rest of this and put it in with the rest of our pepper seasoning. I'm gonna put it there in with this, mix that up. God, it just doesn't feel like I have enough. I don't know what I'm filming. But I guess you don't need too many spices when you have so many fresh vegetables. That's the good news. Alright, so now I'm gonna smash this stuff onto the ribs. Here we go. Quincy Jones ribs. I think that he would like that we were listening to Bone while making these. I think Quincy likes Bone. Bone, 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 bone. Probably not that rendition of Bone, but. Oh, I think we gotta put these on both sides. Okay, this is a rub. Cool. All right, now that that's on there, we line the tin foil with our bed of vegetables here. So bring our vegetables over here. Vegetables. Okay, so I'm making a bed right now. Can't tell that. This is a no-look bed because I'm looking at the camera while I'm making the bed. Wow, there's a lot of veggies here. Kind of went heavy on the onion with the two onions. I was wondering about that.
Okay, this is looking pretty amazing, actually. Our bed of veggies for our ribs. Okay, taking the ribs. I'm going to take this whole little cutting board since I spilled a bunch on it. Bring it right over here. Balance it. Hoping these don't hit the ground.
Okay, so I'm putting it meat down, although it doesn't matter because they're going to have veggies on both sides. But, just so you know, I'm just kind of putting the meat down on that bed first so as to get the meaty side of the ribs, not the rib, not the bone side. All right, so we've got that. Now I'm gonna go ahead and take the rest of these veggies. And we're looking gorgeous. Looking gorgeous, Quincy. Thank you. We can just pour them on. They're all getting used. Oh, this is gorgeous. This is gorgeous. This is gorgeous. I've got a really good feeling about these Quincy Jones Thriller ribs. All right, so I'm gonna package these up, put them in the fridge. 2 days later, we're cooking them. Good day, bye. Oh, she was on. I'll have to edit that out. Skate Park Mark, Grandma's Kitchen. So it's 2 days later, putting the Quincy Jones Thriller ribs in the oven for 6 to 8 hours. And, oh, I almost filmed my mom again. So the deal with this is, see, I make these, right? And then I like make a video. This is all gonna be in the vid. So you take the Quincy Jones Thriller ribs out of the refrigerator, and for 1/2 hour they come up to room temperature. And in the meantime, you preheat your oven to 400. But when you put the ribs in the oven, you turn the oven down to 300. So it's going from 400 to 300 over the course of 6 to 8 hours, who's to say? And we're excited, we're making these ribs. They're gonna be delicious. Here, we're gonna go over here. I thought that it looked a little bit like a UFO. So here's what the ribs look like. It's kind of a, I don't know. It's their Thriller, man. There's some alive gonna come out of that thing. Anyway, we'll put them in the oven as soon as they get to room temperature. Without any further ado, Quincy Jones Thriller ribs going in the oven. Here we go. Got those right there. Got this guy right here. I'm gonna try to lift him with one arm. I'm super strong with the Quincy Jones Thriller ribs. Boom. Here we go. Bang. Oven in Quincy Jones. Now turn down to 300. All right, 300, 6 to 8 hours later, we'll check on them. Back over at Mom's, and it's been a couple, like all day, and I got the call that the fragrance isn't quite as active. It's not as intense, so we're thinking that it's done, and we didn't go the full 8 hours, but we almost went for 6 hours. So that's good enough. 3 o'clock, 6 hours. So Quincy Jones Thriller ribs coming out of the oven right now. Let's take them out. She's in her bed being a bum. No, she went and helped me help Bernadine move all morning, so we've been working pretty hard, so I'm not going to really give her too hard of a time. All right, here we go. She's back in chill mode, and we are in Thriller coming out the oven mode. Here, if I can film this. Dun, 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 dun. And I'm looking right now, and it looks good. The tray is not as full as I was expecting, because the tin foil I didn't think I did a very good job with, but maybe just enough eked out. Let's close this. All right, well, I guess we're gonna have to take off the tin foil and see what we got. Mom, do you wanna come over here and check this out, or? Just showed up at my mom's and I hear football on the TV, which is always good.
It was a really good game with Baylor and West Virginia.
Mm.
Went into overtime.
Just kind of touching the tinfoil here. I'm going to need to get some prongs or something to take it off. It's extremely hot. My mom has such a thing. Less pro looking, but just want to uncover this and get to the thriller ribs. Mm. Steam coming out. Okay. All right, here they are.
What do you think? Do they seem done?
All right, so that's falling off the bone. Here's a bite right here. Might just take that bite right now. Gotta test it out. See how it is. These are delightful. They're really good. They're really good. I don't know if you add anything to them. I don't think you do.
I wouldn't think so.
They're good.
How are they for salt?
So, thanks for tuning in. And my mom is asking how they're doing for salt. And I added that accent, which is MSG, which is like salt on steroids. So I would say they're tasty. Very. All right. Love you guys. Thank you. Bye.